Hi, this is Mihnea, a Romanian living in Bangkok. Welcome to my new show, Reading in Bangkok, in which I share the love and my passion for reading. This episode is an author profile of the book that I'm currently reading. The title of the book is Forsten from Navarone by Alistair MacLean. I've decided to read this book right now at the end of 2014 because I really needed something light and entertaining before I move on to heavier books early on next year. Now, I know it's a second-hand book and you can probably buy it for less than $2 in a second-hand bookstore, but check this out. If you write in the comment section the book you are currently reading, just give me the title and the author, and maybe if you want to write why you chose it and if it's good or not, then I will send you this book by post anywhere in the world. Of course, I'm gonna just pick a random name from the comment section, but the trick is that you also have to subscribe to this YouTube channel. But before you post your comments and subscribe to my YouTube channel, let's do an expose on Alistair MacLean. Okay, maybe expose is too much of a pompous word. Let's do an author profile on Alistair MacLean. Alistair MacLean was a very prolific author. He wrote tons of books and he was read by many, many people. Actually, his books sold millions of copies. He wrote thrillers, spy novels, adventure stories, war novels, and he also wrote a few non-fiction books. And many of his novels were also made into movies. Maybe two of his most popular novels are The Guns of Navarone and Were Eagles There, which of course were later on made into movies. Forsten from Navarone is not the first book that I have read by this author. Actually, almost 10 years ago, I have read another book entitled A Night Without End, which was very entertaining, so I decided to read another book by this writer. Alistair MacLean was a Scottish writer who was born in 1922 in Glasgow, obviously in Scotland. He started as a teacher and later on became a full-time author. Now, isn't that familiar? I am a teacher, I'm not yet a full-time author, but my time is coming soon. So don't forget to buy my books and make me popular and make me famous so that I can quit my job, become a billionaire, and just sit back and relax and enjoy the fame. Until then, let's go back to Alistair MacLean. So although he started as a teacher, before he was a teacher, he was a soldier in the Second World War. He joined the British Navy in 1941 at only 19 years old. And he saw action in the Atlantic and the Mediterranean theaters. He also took part in the Allied invasion of southern France in 1944. And then in 1945, he boarded the Royalist and seized action in the Far East theater, where he helps the Allies with the war against the Japanese. The sad thing is that MacLean struggled with alcoholism, and actually it was the cause of his death. And on one of his drunken ravings, he claimed that he was captured and tortured by the Japanese. Obviously, these claims were unfounded, and even his son and biographer dismissed them. Can you imagine the son telling his dad, "Hey dad, just stick to fiction in your books and don't bring fiction into daily life. You were never captured by the Japanese." But never mind, let's move on. So after the war, he goes back to school and he studies at the University of Glasgow. And upon graduation, he becomes a school teacher. Now, while he was a student, he started writing short stories to supplement his income, and he even won a competition. His major breakthrough came in 1955 with his first published novel, HMS Ulysses, which was based on his wartime experiences. The novel was a great success and secured MacLean the financial security he needed to quit teaching and become a full-time writer. Sounds good, right? Just 2 years later, in 1957, he publishes his second novel, which also becomes a bestseller, The Guns of Navarone, about this fictional Greek island. Alistair MacLean went on to write 28 novels, one collection of short stories, and a few non-fiction books. And he obviously made loads of money. Now, like everyone who makes loads of money, what do? You avoid paying taxes. So he moved to Switzerland as a tax exile. Basically, he had too much money to pay back home, so he moved on to Switzerland to avoid paying taxes. Alistair MacLean passed away in 1987 in Munich, Germany. He left behind a great legacy and many books to read. One of them is Forstand from Navarone. You can have this book by just posting a comment, write the title of the book you're currently reading, the author, and maybe if you want, why you like it or why you chose it. Also, don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel. Once I'm done with the book, I'm gonna randomly choose one of the people who posted a comment. I'm gonna double check that you've also subscribed to my YouTube channel, and I'm gonna send you a message, ask for your postal address, and I'm gonna send this book to you as a New Year present. Until next time, take care. Sawadee ka. Salut. Ciao. This is me.